Hey guys, I wanted to make a video and just kind of go over some of the things that I've learned, and also I have a couple questions, just kind of going over some random things that you know, that I've noticed, that I've kind of taken notes and wanted to talk about. You know, there's a lot of pros and cons to doing you know, Uber and Lyft and for hire services. You know, you're sitting in a car for a long time, but some of the pros, you know, you get to meet really cool people, conversations, and making money. Speaking about money, one of the coolest things I think Uber offers is the fact that as soon as you made a couple hundred bucks or whatever, even if it's $5, you can cash out right away. Now, if you put that into your bank system, which usually takes a debit card, it goes right away. Like, you need gas money, go drive, get 20 bucks, download it to your account. I mean, it is instantaneous. That is awesome. Now, some things, like I said, I'm gonna hit different random topics. In the Uber app, you have your choice of using the Uber navigation or switching it over to Waze. Now, I particularly use Waze. I trust it for traffic a little bit more, and I assure you, you should trust it more than the Uber navigation, because you're forced to use the Uber navigation doing Uber pools. And because it's gonna stop, pick up, drop off, all that kind of stuff. And that makes sense, but it's, sometimes it doesn't. It'll have you circling around the block just to drop some lady off that you're already at her street in front of her house. So that's kind of different. You know, in New York, everyone honks. They honk at you if they like you. They honk at you if they don't like you. They honk if you're too close. They honk if you're too far. You almost have to just completely blur out anybody honking. You know, they honk at you. Don't take offense. Somebody pulls in front of you, let them in. You pull in front of somebody else, chances are they let you in. If that guy doesn't, the next guy does. Now, speaking of something that's pretty unique to most like big cities, is the way you do drive a little bit more aggressively than if you were normally just getting to where you need to go. Okay, say for instance, there's an exit, and off this exit, there's a half a mile line of cars just almost at a standstill. Well, you drive your car almost to that exit and squeeze in. You'll see most of the TLC guys doing that, most other people doing that. You're saving 10 minutes, 5 minutes. If you've got somebody in your car, you know, you might get honked at, but eventually somebody's gonna let you in. So that's at your discretion and at your comfort level. And also getting to know your city or whatever city, you know, or area, you know, you're gonna find the little tricks of the trade. One thing that is done a lot here in New York is intersections. So when the light turns yellow, you're actually in, as you'll see as you take the test, you're actually allowed to go into the yellow, into the intersection before turning. This is all within the exception of blocking the box. And there's certain intersections that are literally lined off and say, you know, don't block the box, where you can't do that. But if you notice, sometimes like a car will come in to turn, they're in the intersection, cars are coming this way, cars are coming that way, but you can also fit two cars in there. And you'll find that if you're the one car and you're waiting behind this other one, somebody else will come in and they'll both make the yellow light, or as it turns red, and go through the intersection, and you're stuck there waiting another, you know, 4 or 5 more minutes. Playing the radio whenever you're driving. Everybody has their own style, their own way of doing things. Particularly, I like to have my radio on just down low. You know, especially if I hear them on the phone or something, they can always request what to play, or, you know, up or down. But I just kind of keep it a low tone, and therefore it's never like a bother or, you know, a nuisance for that matter. I've driven in some cars that, Jesus, just like, turn it down, dude. Now you have to ask. That's, I don't know, that's poor ratings as far as I'm concerned. Here's another topic. I noticed that on a lot of other TLC cars, they will have their front seat pushed all the way up. Okay, there's one or two reasons. And it's not to give that person in the back more room. It's so that another person doesn't sit, they're not encouraged to sit in the front seat. Because I've had to get in the front seat, so I'm a tall guy, and it's almost, they have to like pull their backpack off the front seat floorboard, and they kind of look at you funny. I don't do that whatsoever. I encourage, if somebody wants to sit in the front seat, by all means, please, you know, sit in the front seat. Also, because I'm tall, my seat has to go back. I've had plenty of room. I haven't had to move up. But I don't want the other person to go, why do they have so much room and I don't? And then they would think about it. So just keep your seats normal. I don't understand why. And if you go out and look, especially in New York City, half of these drivers, they got their seat front, their passenger side seat way up. It just, you know, doesn't really make sense to me, but that's my take on it. Also when driving, I think, you know what, after the promotions and stuff are done, you just kind of want to focus on a goal, whether that goal is usually financial, you know, whether it's $200, $350, whatever it is, get up early in the morning, catch that early morning time. I've heard, but I haven't experienced it yet, that 4 a.m. till, what is it, 12 noon is like prime time. They make all their money and they go home. I've yet to really get up that early and test that out, but I've heard from several sources this is a great thing to do. And I think my personal goal would be like $200 5 days a week. I think that would be great and doable, especially here and living in Williamsburg, cruising around where I can just go around my, you know, my area and pick up rides. Pretty good. You know, I find the app, like I said, very user-friendly for Uber, and I haven't tried Lyft or the other guys yet. I'm going to give you guys more updates on that. Anyway, there's some random thoughts. Give me your thoughts. Put some comments down below. I'm going to have new videos coming out, and please, if you like what you're seeing, please subscribe, give a thumbs up, and a shout-out if you will. All right, guys, I'll see you on the road.